Whether editing a photo or an illustration, you can use Generative Fill to add content by typing a simple prompt.
My name is Jesus Ramirez. In the next few minutes, I will show you how to add content to an image with Generative Fill in Adobe Firefly.
From the Firefly website at firefly.adobe.com, scroll down and click the Generative Fill card. Then, you can either click the Upload button to find an image on your computer or simply drag one into this box. I'll drag a JPEG in. From here, you can use the Insert tool to add content to parts of your image using a text prompt. For example, we can add an object to his hand. First, select the Insert tool and make sure to activate the Add button to add to the selection. Then paint over the area where you want to add the new object. The checkerboard pattern indicates where the generated content will appear. These areas will be replaced entirely by new content. In the prompt input box, simply type red coffee cup and generate the image content by clicking the blue generate button or pressing the enter key on Windows, which is the return key on the Mac. I'll use the keyboard shortcut. Firefly will now generate three variations. You can click on the individual variations in the film strip to apply them to your image to see which one looks best. If you want to see more variations, click on the More button to generate three additional variations. Then, click on the right arrow icon to cycle through the new variations, and click on the left arrow icon to go back to the original three. Select the one you like best, and click the Keep button to apply the generation to your photo. Generative Fill also does a fantastic job replacing elements with new content. For example, we can replace the street with a canal. I'll start by opening the brush settings. From here, you can adjust the brush size, the brush hardness, which determines the sharpness of the brush edge, and the brush opacity. First, reduce the brush size by dragging the brush size slider to the left. A smaller brush gives you more precise control over the areas you paint. If you prefer keyboard shortcuts, you can press the left and right bracket keys to resize the brush on the fly. The bracket keys are next to the letter P in North American keyboards. This is the method I'll use going forward. Start by painting over this couple, then continue to paint over the rest of the street. For better precision, work on the edges first using a small brush. Remember, you can use the bracket keys to resize your brush on the fly. Work on both sides of the street, then you can use a right bracket key to increase the brush size and paint over the remaining areas without needing much precision. When you're done, simply enter the prompt, Venetian Canal. Then generate this prompt by tapping the Enter key on Windows, which is the return key on the Mac. And Firefly will do a fantastic job with all the variations. The perspective, lighting, and reflections all match the scene, creating a seamless addition. I like this one the best. The reflections on the water look incredible. Press the Keep button to apply the generation. And now you can click the Download button on the top right to download the edited image to your computer.
Now that you know how to add content to an image with Generative Fill in Adobe Firefly, try it with your photos. Again, my name is Jesus Ramirez. Thank you for watching.